I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. If you listen carefully, you'll observe that each character in this tale is represented by a different instrument of the orchestra. For instance, the bird by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The grandfather by the bassoon. By the three horns. Peter by the string quartet. And the rifle shots by the kettle drum and the big drum. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into a big green meadow. On the branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. All is quiet, chirped the bird gaily. Soon a duck came waddling round. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Flew down upon the grass, settled next to the duck, and shrugged her shoulders. "What kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" said she. To this the duck replied, "Well, what kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. And argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought, the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab her. Stealthily, she crept towards her on her velvet paws. "Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat, from the middle of the pond, the cat crawled around the tree and thought, is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away. Just then, Grandpapa came out. He was angry because Peter had gone to the meadow. It is a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do? Peter paid no attention to Grandfather's words. Boys like Peter are not afraid of wolves. grandfather took Peter by the hand, led him home, and locked the gate. Peter gone, then a big gray wolf came out of the forest. The cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked and in her excitement jumped right out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, nearer, catching up with her, and suddenly he got her. And with one gulp, swallowed her down. Now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. The wolf prowled around and around the tree, looking up at them with greedy eyes. Meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. Then he ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was prowling stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." Bird almost touched the wolf's head with her wings, while the wolf snapped at her from this side and from that. How the bird worried the wolf. How he wanted to catch her. But the bird was clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso. Carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. The other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter. Just then, some hunters came out of the wood. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they came. Thank you. Peter, sitting in the tree, cried, "Don't shoot. Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. All you have to do is to help us take him to the zoo." And so off they started to the zoo. And now imagine the triumphal procession. With Peter proudly marching in the lead. After him came the hunters, leading the wolf that Peter had caught. Winding up the procession, Grandfather and the Cat. Grandfather shook his head and grumbled, but if Peter hadn't caught the wolf, what then? Above them flew Birdie, chirping merrily. "My, what fine ones we are, Peter and I. Look what we have caught." And if you listen very carefully, you'd hear the duck quacking in the wolf's belly. Because the wolf in his hurry had swallowed her alive.